Hey dolls, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'm so happy that I managed to do another look for you guys. This was a highly requested look, a smokey eye. I've just added a bit of green to mine, but if you're interested in this look, just stay tuned and keep watching. So I've done my brows already. I'm gonna put a link in the description box so that you guys can see how I do them. Right now I'm just using a modern matte by BH Cosmetics, and I'm using a soft brown as a transition colour. I'm placing that in my crease and I'm just gently blending it out. And then now I'm using Blacktrack fluid line by MAC. I'm using that as a kind of a base for my smokey eye. I find that black sort of powdery eyeshadows don't make my eyes dark enough, so I use it as a base, then I put like a black eyeshadow on top of it just to give it the extreme dimension. And then now I'm just going back in with a bit of brown and I'm just blending that through with my blending brush. I'm going to be adding a bit of green to my smokey eye just because I like how it looks on me. I'm going to be using those two greens from the BH Cosmetic palette. Right now I'm just applying it in the crease just because I want to give it a bit of depth. So I'm just going to apply that and then blend it through with a bit more brown on top. And this eye is going to be a repetition of what I've done to the other eye. And just to make sure that there's no harsh division between my concealer and eyeshadow, I'm just going in with another blending fluffy brush just to sort of buff it out a bit so that it's got a really nice blend. And again, going in with my favourite primer of all times. This is the HD Photo Ready Primer from NYX. It's my bae. I absolutely love it. It gives me that finish I'm always going for. And it looks amazing on camera. Okay, so I'm doing things slightly different in this video than I do the rest. I'm actually putting on my eyelashes before I put on my foundation. The reason why I'm doing this is because I find that when I'm wearing a heavy eye makeup, I really like to see it all come together before I put on the foundation. I just think it looks really boring and empty when the foundation's on and I don't have my lashes, because I think my lashes complete that look that I'm going for. And these lashes are the Vintinelli Mink Eyelashes. They're available to purchase on my website and I'll put the link in the description box below. I'm going in with my favourite foundation of all times. This is the Foundation Stick by BlackOpal. I'm right now wearing the Truly Topaz, and then I'm going to go in with Beautiful Bronze on the outskirts of my face. The reason why I use two colours is because I find that when I blend them together, it gives me my perfect tone and shade. Thank you. Cosmetics. I'm using color Pure Beige and I'm putting that in all the areas of my face that I want to lift. I apply it on all the areas that I want to be highlighted, so all the areas where natural lighting will reflect on the skin. Working that in a little bit. I'm not blending it out with that brush, I'm just sort of working it into the skin a bit more. Now I'm blending in concealer using a stippling brush by Real Techniques. I really love this brush. I really love this brush because I find that it really, really helps to push it into the skin, so it looks really flawless. Contour with BlackOpal's foundation stick. This one is in shade Black Walnut. Again, I really love it. It gives me that really nice cut on the cheek. Again, I'm just working that in with the stippling brush from Real Techniques. So now I'm just setting the highlighted areas on my face using MUA Cosmetics setting powder. It helps to remove the shine and to just brighten up the highlighted areas a bit more. Using the same green that I used on my eyes earlier on, I'm gonna apply it in the just beneath the waterline, just to brighten the eye and not make it so dull and boring. So I'm going back in, but this time I'm adding a bit of brown because I just wanted the warmth back in my eyes. I thought that the green took it away a little bit, it made it too bright. So the brown would sort of just make it a little bit more subtle. And then to really make it a smoky eye, I have to add my favourite eyeliner in the waterline, and that's Feline by MAC. Powder. I'm using Mineralise Skinfinish by MAC in shade Dark. I don't actually know the name of that particular eyeshadow, but I do know that it's from the Warm Neutral palette by MAC. I really, really love that palette. It's actually one of my favourites. But that eyeshadow, I really, absolutely love. I use it as a highlight. It gives me like a really nice gold shimmer, and I also use it in my tear duct just to brighten my eyes a bit. Now I'm contouring using Covergirl. Again, I did say that I would have the name. I would actually put it in the description boxes down below. Going in on my cheeks using Raizin by MAC. Using that same eyeshadow from the Warm Neutral palette to highlight my Cupid's bow. I do this literally just before I line my lips, and I'm using Bittersweet lip liner by MAC to line my lips. This lipstick is called Fleshpot by MAC. Now I'm just dusting off the excess powder from the setting powder that I used earlier to set my highlight. Face using the same eyeshadow that comes in the Warm palette by MAC. Look at it, I just love it. I think it's amazing for smoky eye. It doesn't give the sort of white color highlight, but a really nice gold. Using In Extreme Dimension mascara by MAC just to liven up my bottom lashes. I think they look really useless without mascara on them. And now I'm just setting my face again using Makeup Revolution oil fixing setting spray. And there we have it, dolls. I hope you enjoyed the video. I really loved making this one for you guys. It's one I can't believe I hadn't done this look before, but if you do like it, subscribe, like and comment, and tell me what you want to see next. Bye. Oh,